Flag Day. We're hoping to make this an annual event, and hopefully it gets bigger and bigger. Some facts about flags and Flag Day. Our flag was first adopted on June 14th in 1777 by the Continental Congress. The flag represents our freedom and is a symbol of the U.S. Since 1777, the flag has held a field of blue with stars for each state and in the Union, and red and white stripes. I don't know. In 1795, the number of stripes was increased to 15. And aside here, that's when Kentucky became part of the Union, my home state. And then in 1818, they decided that would be self-defeating, so they went back to the 13 stripes. And it's remained there since. Since 1818, a star has been added for each new state on July 4th in the year after the state's admission. In 1861 was the first year that a flag day was suggested. We were in the middle of the Civil War, of course. On June 14th, 1877, Congress instructed that the U.S. flag be flown from all public buildings. And in 1916, President Woodrow Wilson issued a proclamation that officially established June 14th as Flag Day. And then National Flag Day was established by Congress in 1949. Two or three states actually make it an official state holiday. I know Pennsylvania is one of those states. And I didn't know, but Quincy, Massachusetts has been holding a Flag Day parade since 1952. So we'll have to check it out sometime. An interesting fact too, the Army was also founded on June 14th in 1775. So June 14th is an important day to our country. And I'd like to end it with one quote by President Calvin Coolidge. "We identify the flag with almost everything we hold dear on earth: peace, security, liberty, our family, our friends, our home. But when we look at our flag and behold it emblazoned with all our rights, we must remember that it is equally a symbol of our duties. Every glory that we associate with it is the result of duty done." I thought that was an appropriate quote. So Troop 75 is here, and they are going to present the flag and then hang it on our flagpole. The flagpole, so you know, was once on the Chelmsford Common. It's been out here 10 years or so, and we're very proud that it's here. So I will turn it over to the troop.
That is a terrific question. Look, it's in part why I ran for this seat. There are too many women who aren't able to actually participate in our economy. because they do the cost-benefit analysis all the time. How much does it cost for me for childcare versus how much am I going to get in my paycheck? I felt that right when I had my first daughter, and I know millions of women do. We need affordable daycare in this country. We need universal kindergarten in this country. That does two things. Yep, that you can clap for that. It does two things. It closes the achievement gap in our country. We don't need to read another study to know that early childhood development closes the achievement gap well up into your adult years. It also gets more women off the sidelines and gives them the empowerment to jump into the workforce, which so many women want to do. And that's an issue that comes up on Ed and Labor. I mean, look, paid leave, we need to join the rest of the world in allowing paid leave so that we can take care of our loved ones, our in-laws, our parents, our spouses, our children, and not be dinged for that. And there is a plan to do that. It's modest. It's a nominal amount out of folks' paycheck that goes into a fund that's matched by employers and allows folks to take that leave when they need it. Equal pay for equal work. This one is near and dear to my heart. I worked in tech. I felt it every day. We haven't made much progress on that. And we need to have paycheck fairness. We need to make that a thing of the past where the same job that's done by a woman is paid the same amount as her male counterpart. This hurts women across the board, but it most disproportionately harms our women of color. If a woman today makes 82 cents on the dollar compared to her male counterpart, that dips to like 60, 50 cents when compared to African-American women, Latino women. So we need to fix this problem once and for all, and it's one that I get to do on the Ed and Labor Committee, and what I'm proud to do on the Ed and Labor Committee.